Speaking of lovely people, we are hanging out outside near the campfire with a frequent guest on our show. She's a great mom, a great wife, and a great cook. This is Sarah Gunther. Good morning.
Hey, God. Nice to see you again,
great
Amy.
To see you, too.
What a beautiful day to be out,
It's
huh?
a perfect day, and Sarah has been talking about this forever. She took a bunch of her family's recipes and finally did it, right?
Yes.
It's a lot of work. She put together a family cookbook, and we'll get you more information on how you can learn more about that on our website, but lots of great recipes in here. So tell us what we're making.
Well, today is we're going to do a bacon wrap stuffed walleye, and this kind of got the inspiration when Carl and I used to go canoe camping up in Canada, and you're in the middle of nowhere and you're starving and you're like, I would love to have some type of gourmet meal. So we came up with this.
I love it.
With the fresh walleye right out of the water.
Ooh, nothing better than
Nothing better. You know, and it's super simple. So we're going to actually put it right in the pan here and prepare it there so we don't have a mess either because you're camping.
Right, you know? Exactly. You want to keep it easy. Okay.
So we're going to lay the fillets out kind of initially so that we can stuff them. We actually just use stovetop stuffing because you're camping again.
Keep it easy.
Bring it along. Yeah.
Right.
So then what I do initially is kind of season the fish.
Okay.
You know, and you can use like garlic seasonings or whatever we can here. A little Old Bay is always good because that goes so well with fish.
Yes, it does.
And it's super simple. Then we're going to take the stuffing and stuff it, so I'll have you start stuffing.
So is this just made according to package directions?
Kind of? Yeah, just made stovetop. And you know, when you're camping, you got to be light.
Right.
You know, so you can't have a lot of stuff. So the fish come out of the water. We have this nice little box of stuff. And then the bacon, you know, is pretty easily transported as well. And
do you usually cook it before you go camping?
Yeah, I usually try to, and if you can't, that's fine too. You know, it just depends on, you know, like when we used to be on the water, by the time you got there, you were just happy to get something put together. But if you had a campsite, you'd have plenty of time to kind of just, you know, get the bacon going a little bit.
Okay.
Okay.
So there's our bacon that we've started a little bit.
Yes. And so then we're just going to put another fillet here up on top, and actually we'll do the same with this one here. And then we're going to actually wrap these.
Yum.
So, and what I like to do is just kind of tuck the bacon underneath here.
And that we kind of pre-started just a little bit. You don't have to cook it all the way, but just start it a little bit.
Just a little bit. And if you want to grab one of those toothpicks out, we'll break that in half. And that just kind of holds this bacon into place very nicely. And we'll set this one over here as well. Okay. And then I'm just going to take these and hold the bacon into place. There we go.
Yeah, this is looking like some serious good camping dinner.
Oh, yeah. You know, I mean, look at it. We've taken just a couple minutes and
it's like three ingredients.
Yeah
it's easy.
It's easy. And we'll put this last piece of bacon underneath here. Same thing.
I'm imagining that bacon is going to, the fat from the bacon, it's not only going to give flavor, but it's going to keep that fish nice and moist.
Oh, yeah, exactly. And then we're going to wrap it in little foil packets. So if you want to start opening up a pack.
Now, these are genius. Again, one less thing you have to take camping if you don't want to bring cooking spray. This is non-stick.
Non-stick, yeah.
Which is great.
I started that a little while ago, and it's just like you say, easy.
Yep.
Here, it kind of help you bring it over.
Yep. Here so we can
go.
Just wrap up one of them. Okay, so a nice foil pouch. And now tell us about this getup.
This is your tripod, and we bring this along camping all the time, and it's so nice because, you know, we've got the fish on there right now. You could do hamburgers, hot dog, you know, I do zucchini on the grill, you know, any type of vegetable. The kids love to, you know, just put whatever on there, and it works
it's
so
fantastic
nice.
And fantastic. Real reasonable.
Yes, $20-some at the store. I mean,
and this looks like it's been well used, and
it goes up and down. So if the fire gets too hot, you just raise it, and you're just perfect, and you don't have to burn your food.
Do you normally cook with the foil packets on these, or do you, you know, both?
I do both. You know, for the hamburgers, hot dogs directly on the grill, I do chicken on the grill. But then the foil packets, like fish and the veggies and stuff, I usually do in the foil
packet. They need to be a little more tender with those.
Yeah.
Okay, so on it goes.
Yeah.
And then about how long do these cook?
Well, you know, I usually keep them on there probably for about 10 or 15 minutes, and then you just kind of open the packet at some point and check, and if the fish looks you know, it's flaky, then we're good to go. I've got a hot pan over here to kind of help you drag one of these off.
I'm used to doing this.
All right.
But But super. Be careful. That's the key with opening these careful. Foil packets.
And, you know, it's just, it's steaming, it's beautiful.
Okay,
I mean, look at that.
Yum.
It just doesn't get any better.
No. Yeah. Sign me up for that. Oh, that looks so good. And coming up, we're going to make dessert on the grill. What are we making?
We are making pudgy pies. This is a thing that our neighborhood has done for years, and the kids come around and they do cherry and they do raspberry and pizzas, and grown-ups do Rubens. It's going to be awesome.
Oh, it sounds really fun. Thanks, Sarah.